What's up, friend? Hector here, strongestheck.com, with this week's Movement Monday for the week. So we started up a whole new series. Last week I went into talking about the shoulder and the wrist, and we're going to continue with that on this second part. And what we're going to be focusing on today is opening up the chest and getting those shoulders into extension. So because of our lifestyle nowadays, and sometimes even our sport and activities, we spend a lot of time in flexion. And flexion is just that, like, shoulders starting to round over, constant rounding of our back, and we don't spend enough time in extension. So today's little mobility drill and core stability drill is really going to emphasize that the wrists, okay, and the shoulders in extension and extension of the thoracic part of your spine. Now, I'm going to show you a couple of different variations and how to ease your way into this. If you've got some mileage on you, maybe you've got some wrist problems. We're going to be spending a lot of time on our hands, and that can put a lot of stress, a lot of that compression on the wrist. And so, I'm going to show you one of my favorite, like, little wrist decompressions that I learned from master instructors Zar Horton and Andrea Chang, my mentors. And so I'm going to show you a really good, very simple wrist decompression. And a lot of this material that we'll be kind of integrating with the mobility secrets and even the Movement Monday is a lot of it's based on a movement system founded by Peter Lakatosh. He's a master instructor with Strong First called the GFM, Ground Force Method. So you'll see a lot of this that we incorporate into the certifications that we teach. So basically, we're going to be working on a crab position. You've probably seen this. You probably even used this as a kid, and you see kids do this a lot. But it's great for the wrists, great for the shoulders, and it's actually fun to do. And I'm going to show you a couple different progressions how to get into that. So pretty simple. We're going to start. I want you to start on your butt. Knees are up. Okay. Hands. A couple of different ways to place your hands. So I'm going to show you a not so stressful position for your wrist, and then I'm going to show you an extreme, a kind of intermediate, and then more of an extreme position for your wrist. And this is just something to play around with as a progression. So this crab position may feel very uncomfortable for you, especially if you're really tight through the chest and the shoulders, and being in this extended position like this is going to be uncomfortable. You'll feel a big stretch in your pecs, a good big stretch in the front part of your shoulder, and that's okay. That's just a natural progression to it. So, whenever you're on your butt, for the least amount of, strain or pressure on the shoulders, you'll have your hands pointed out sideways, like, just like so, okay? And you'll be in this crab position like this, okay? Chest is up, you're not sinking into your neck, okay? Chest is up, okay? Butt's off the ground, and my hands are pointed out. Okay, that's going to put the less amount of stress on your shoulder. Stress in a good way. Okay, the next one would be turning your hands straight back. You're going to feel a big stretch down your forearms, again, because we're always in flexion, especially if you use kettlebells a lot and you like to do presses and swings and snatches. You're constantly using the flexors of your forearm, and you're really not getting a whole lot of extension and external rotation and extension. That's a big one. So this one is going to turn back just like so. You're going to feel a lot more, a bigger stretch here in the shoulder because you're fully externally rotating the hands, and you'll have your hands back just like this. And I'm feeling a really gnarly stretch just by being in this position. Okay, so for me, I've got a history of a few injuries from Jiu-Jitsu. A lot of hyperextension of my elbows from getting armbarred by some really badass jiu-jitsu guys. So putting my arms in complete extension like this doesn't hurt, but it puts a big stretch, which is the reason why I'm doing this, because everything I show you in the Movement Monday series and in my Mobility Secrets program, everything I show you is actually stuff I actually do that's helped to improve my performance, keep me on the mat training jiu-jitsu, and reduce injuries, reduce possible injuries, okay? So I'm gonna turn this way. I really feel the stretch more so on my right side. So when I turn my hand back like this, you're probably gonna see this hand kind of go crazy because it's really stretching, okay? So I'm getting a huge stretch out of my biceps, my elbow, my forearm flexors, That's gnarly right there. Okay, chest is up, and that is gonna put a huge amount of stress here, in a good way, okay? Less is hand turned out, this is even more. Now this next one is a little more intense, not as intense as this one, but you basically have your hands forward like this, okay? This one can be challenging if you struggle to be able to keep your shoulders connected back and down. And you may struggle to have that because you're already in this position, so we don't want to give up the shoulder. See this here? I don't want to give up my shoulder. I want to still be able to connect my shoulders back and down. Okay? But this is less stress on the arms, on the elbows. Okay? A little more extreme. Okay? Less stress, but I risk losing my shoulder if I lack the mobility. This is kind of a neutral one. This allows you to keep the shoulders back and down. And this really hits the elbows, the bicep, the pecs, and the shoulder. Okay? And it's really putting my wrist in some pretty extreme extension too. Okay? So ease into it with neutral. Okay? A little more stress if you can keep the shoulders back. And then this is gonna be the extreme one here. All right, so now we're gonna work on the rotators. So one of the ways to get the rotator cuff to activate reflexively without you can't consciously engage your rotator. Your rotator cuffs fire reflexively by two responses is through compression and distraction. So compression is putting weight down. So like being in this crab position, the moment I put my hand down, rotator cuff has to turn on. Distraction is hanging from a bar, doing a farmer's carry. That distraction and kind of pulling the shoulder out gets the rotators to fire. That's why farmer's carries are a great exercise to improve shoulder health and your posture. Okay, so we're gonna work on the compression part of that rotator cuff stimulation, I guess. And the moment I put my hands down, I'm compressing the joint and it's causing the rotators to fire. Now that they're on, I'm actively pushing the ground away. I'm not sinking into my neck. I'm actively pushing the ground away. Now, the first progression is you're gonna raise one leg at a time, just like this. So when I raise this one leg, I'm kind of like a three-legged chair. Okay, requiring a little more core activation for my midsection. Okay, now I'm going to raise one hand. I'm gonna be in the three-legged chair the other way. That's really gonna challenge my shoulder that I'm stabilizing on. Really gonna hit the midsection. Okay, hands are turned out, chest is up. Okay, and it'll be a slight shift to my left. Okay, I don't want my body to change. I wanna try to stay exactly where I'm at. Here. Okay, I don't want to sink, I don't want anything to change. Okay, now that I've done my legs, I've done my hand, now I'm going to do opposites. I'm going to cross midline by opposite arm, opposite leg. Okay, so this is literally like a crawling pattern. Just a little different because now I'm moving opposite arm and opposite leg, and I could easily crawl towards you. I can go sideways, etc. But here's the next transition that we're gonna focus on, okay, is rotating. So opposite arm and opposite leg, boom, simultaneous. Now I'm going to tuck this leg underneath and come into this 6-point crawl position. And as I do that, I'm moving my shoulder through a range of motion. So that's really gonna require some stability. And now I'm gonna work on the mobility to make sure it all locks in, okay? So I'll face you, okay? To go back, I step my foot up, pick my hand up. Now, where my hand was right here. I'm going to put my back leg where my hand used to be. Pick my hand up, pick my leg up, step through, put my foot where my hand was, and now I'm here in the crab. Okay? To come back, opposite arm and opposite leg, I'm gonna swing through, I pivot on the ball with my foot, and I come back down. Foot, hand comes up, knee comes up, I step through, put my hand on the ground, and now I'm back. Okay? This may look familiar to a get up, right? The get up is the exact same pattern. So this is a great way to work on your get up skills without having to do the get up and without needing the kettlebell. My hand goes slightly turned out. I step my foot up. Now look, I'm in the half kneeling windmill essentially. I step through, but instead of sitting down like the get up, I put my foot on the ground. Okay? I don't lose the integrity of this shoulder. I don't let my neck fall into my shoulder, and I put my hand down. And you can do a little circle, right? To have fun with it. You can do a little circle. You're really limited by your imagination, but that's really gonna hit the shoulders, okay? It's really gonna strengthen the core, it's gonna strengthen your hands, and it's fun to do. All right, so that's pretty much it for this week's Movement Monday for the week. Working on that crab position that's gonna hit the wrist and hit the shoulder. And that's what we're really focusing on over this three-part video series is the shoulders and the wrist. So give that a try, play around with it, add it to your daily practice as one of your mobility recharges or something like that, and just have fun with it. And you're really gonna see the shoulders start to open up, and it's gonna make all your overhead movements like pressing, push pressing, jerking, snatching, all those overhead movements, you're gonna be so much more efficient because you're able to access that mobility, okay? So give that a try. Let me know how it goes by leaving a comment below. I've left a few details in the description area if you have any questions. So that's all I got for you guys this week. Again, I'm Hector with strongesthec.com with this week's Movement Monday for the week.